hills and fair as these green foreign hills may be, they are not the hills of
Tuesday. I'm looking tired and feeling quite sick. I felt like there was something missing in my day-to-day life. So I quickly opened the wardrobe, pulled out some jeans and a t-shirt that seemed clean, topped it off with a pair of old shoes that were ripped around the seams. And I thought, these shoes just don't suit me. Hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything's right. I said, hey, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling, it's so right. And oh, short on money but long on time, slowly strolling in the sweet sunshine. And I'm running late and I don't need an excuse, so I'm wearing my brand new shoes. Woke up late one Thursday and I'm seeing stars as I'm rubbing my eyes, and I felt like there were 2 days missing as I focused on the time. Then I made my way to the kitchen, but I had to stop from the shock of what I found. A room full of all of my friends all dancing round and round. And I thought, hello, new shoes, bye-bye blues. Hey,
Take me wandering through these streets where bright lights and angels meet. Stone to stone, they take me on. I'm walking till the break of dawn. Take me wandering through these streets where bright lights and angels meet. Stone to stone, they take me on. I'm walking till the break of dawn. Hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything is right. I said, hey, I put some new shoes on and everybody's smiling. It's so inviting. No, short on money but long on time. Slowly strolling in the sweet sunshine. And I'm running late and I don't need an excuse. So wearing my brand new shoes. Oh, hey, I put some new shoes on and suddenly everything is right. So I'm wearing my brand new shoes.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness. To boredom overtook us, and he began to speak. He said, son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, if you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. And when he finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out a cigarette, faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the gambler, he broke even. But in his final words, I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold. Know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. Sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count when the deal is done.
just like the dance floor. All that we need is here in the still of the night. All of the words could never describe the wonder, the feeling of peace when everything is just right. Here we both stand, longing to hold one another, never to wake, wrapped in a sweet summer air, wishing that we could stay in this moment forever, into the night, young, pure and free. Take my summer would seem so long, and we'd sing our favorite songs. We heard them on the radio, it was long ago. An endless night and laughter until the dawn, a time when our dreams were born, paved the way for all we have and all we need. Take my stars
Let's go. But she moves like lightning, and she counts to three. Then she turns out all the lights and says she's coming for me. Now put your hands up, this is a heist. And there's no one in here living gonna make it out alive. Load it up when the sun comes down. Getaway car for two young lovers. Me and the girl straight out of town. Over the hills and undercover, undercover, undercover. Sky, you better throw a party on the day that I die.
Good afternoon. My name is Rona Cathcart and I'm the minister at Inverary West Parish Church. On behalf of the family, I'd like to thank you all for being here today, and that includes those of you who are over at the Kirk Hall or joining from the live stream at home. The family would also like me to express thanks for the massive amount of cards and flowers that they have received and which they deeply appreciate as a gesture of support and love for Sands and the family. You're cordially invited to join them for light refreshments at the Kemnay Bowling Club after the internment. And there's also an opportunity to donate towards the work of Kemnay community groups if you wish to do so, if you haven't already done so. We're here today to remember and to give thanks for the life on earth of Sandy, or Sands, Elric, a family-loving brother, husband, father, grandfather, hotelier and friend, with a heart for hospitality and a gift for using music to foster community spirit. We're here to share our grief, to say goodbye, to celebrate the fullness of Sandy's life, and together to seek comfort and peace. Sandy's life was full of a wide range of music, as we were able to experience listening to the playlist coming in. We're beginning our service today with a familiar and well-loved hymn sung not just in the church, but in connection with Sandy's playlist. They're also one that was recorded by extraordinary artists such as Mahalia Jackson, Judy Collins, Aretha Franklin, Elvis Presley, and Rod Stewart. Let's sing together, Amazing Grace. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, these are difficult times and our hearts are sore. In the midst of loss and sadness, we are grateful for your guiding presence. When feelings of helplessness overcome us, we can find comfort and hope and strength in the love that created us and which longs to hold us safe. Lord, you know how each one of us is made. You understand the mixed feelings which often accompany the loss of someone close to us. Some of us will find comfort in words, others in tears, still others in silence, in projects to keep us busy, or when we can, in the company of others. Hold us tenderly as we look for comfort in your word. May your presence and the sharing of our grief help us find the peace we seek. Amen. A few years ago, I had the privilege of conducting San's daughter Charlie's wedding. At the wedding, the Doric wedding toast by Sheena Blackhall was read by one of Charlie and Andrew's friends. At the time, I made reference to a Doric translation of the well-known Shepherd Psalm, Psalm 23. Given San's strong Doric connection, I thought it appropriate to use this setting of Psalm 23 for our Bible reading today, if you will forgive what is undoubtedly my slightly dodgy Doric accent. And it goes, "The Lord is my shepherd, I'll nae want for naething. He curries me doon in the green gerse hame. Like sparkling waters, he caws me to quietness. He bozies my soul back to life just the same. For his name's sake, he leads me through stracht and richt pathways, though I gang by the glen of death's shadow forby. I'll fear me nae evil, your crummock will curb me, but your crook will gie comfort, for you're walking nigh. My table you've set oot a fair o' my face, Lord. With oil o' anointing, you've blissit my croon. My quakes rinnin' o'er, and guid and love chase me all my days till your hoose, far for I I'll lay doon." Amen. I'd like to invite San's brother Billy forward to give the first part now of the family eulogy.
My parents, Sandy and Jess Elric, bought the Burnett Arms in 1961 and moved in with my sister Evelyn, my brother Sands, and the baby of the family, me. Being brought up in the Tell was one big playground. That was until we all ended up having to work in the hotel. Evelyn, being the oldest, a fact that I never tired of reminding her, was the first, and she worked in the restaurants and the bars and became the head waitress of the hotel. Life in the hotel was busy with Sunday night dances in the hall, the bars, the restaurants, and of course, the hotel residents. Our dad found out quick that when guests checked in and dad delivered their bags to their rooms and finding out he was the owner, he would not get a tip. The solution was simple. He took the nickname and of the porter. Thus, delivering the bags, he would inform the guests if they needed anything, just ask for the porter and receive the tip. This started a trend and soon everybody had a nickname. Stovey, Uncle, the Maharaja, Double Sandy, and my mum, the Duchess, etc. Young Sandy became Sands, and for some unknown reason, I was given the nickname the Menace. My father saw an opportunity with the hall and the function room to introduce discos. Sands was nominated to become the DJ and equipment duly bought and set up. Unfortunately, there was a slight problem. Sands was so shy, he didn't speak. He would play the records, but not talk. Over the next few months, Sands began to warm to his task, and soon it was time to formally advertise these discos. We needed a name. Sands, being Alexander Charles Elric, the disco was named the Ace of Spades. At this stage in his life, Sands had two passions. There was football and cars. Unfortunately, his liking for fast cars almost cost him his life. He bought himself an RS2000. The fact that he didn't have a license at the time was a mere technicality. He and a friend decided to go and visit my sister, who lived in Bedford. On the return journey, unfortunately, they had an accident that left him seriously hurt with life-changing injuries. His friend was unhurt. Sands made a full recovery, but never lost his love for fast cars. Sands, my older brother, had a fantastic white and black Capri, an MG, and a Porsche, to name but a few of his cars. Sands fell in love with Evelyn in 1987, and they got married. However, like many good men before and after, the Porsche had to go, as he could not afford to insure his new wife in such a fast car. Sands' first love, above all other things, yes, even Celtic, that was a passion of his, was his family. I will now pass back to Rona to talk about Sands, the family man, on behalf of Evelyn, Nolani, Charlie, and Aidan. Rest in peace, my brother.
Thank you, Billy. Taking up now with the family's words, which they have shared and which I will be sharing with you. Evelyn met Sands in April of 1987. You could describe it as a whirlwind romance, as they married only 5 months later. It's sad to think of all the years they were due, but at this time we have been reflecting on the 37 years they did have together. The good times and the not so good times that all families would have. They have been through a lot, they loved deeply, and they were best friends. They also worked together over the years in not only the Burnet, but other hospitalities over the years. Sands was notorious for including the family in his endeavors. We'd always joke, cheap labor. During the years, there were many adventures which were the result of hard work and long hours. Sands excelled in any business task or charity event they would be organizing, along with his famous discos, to provide a fantastic life for Evelyn and his family. These events also did a lot for the community, and the cards received over the past week show testament to the impact he made on others' lives. It doesn't matter where you go in life or how much you have, it's who you have beside you. Nolani, their oldest, Charlie and Aidan, now grown with their own families. Nolani with children Kaylin and Ashton, Charlie and husband Andrew with children Millie and Otto, Aidan and his partner Tina, and son Clayton. Sands was a generous soul, and no favor required was too great a task. Even the DIY jobs, which he would give 100% to, but perhaps not the most finesse at times. One of his favorite tasks was hanging pictures, and therefore there would be holes in the walls everywhere. You'd often find him tinkering in the garage. He spent a lot of time in there, claiming to be having a tidy out. However, we are convinced he was just moving it round from one place to another, measuring things up rather than getting rid of things or neatening things up. Sands lived for his grandchildren. He would be at every event, for example, grandson Ashton's football. Sands was his biggest supporter and was always there to give his best football advice because, of course, he knew best. He would wind the kids up, much to the older kids' dismay, but that was a big part of his family. As his friends would say, he loved a wind up. He was such a topper. Kaylin, as she would describe, was dragged out on all the walks, which she did secretly enjoy. Millie would FaceTime Granda from Paris all the time. He was such a loved Granda, their world. Sans absolutely loved a Skecher. His favorite shoes, there was always a new pair. On any shopping trip, he would visit the Skecher shop and would buy Skechers for the grandchildren. He'd spoil them, anything they wanted. That's what the best grandparents do. Sans loved nothing more than a busy house at Reunion, the family home since 1993. It was when Sans was at his happiest, and you could see the pride he had for his family and the life he had built. Family dinners and events in the diary, whether it would be a night out with Evelyn to see a show, a football game with the boys, or a holiday or spontaneous outing for ice cream, Evelyn's favorite. This gave Sans much energy and happiness, the excitement of it all, and being with those he loved. He would always have the next suggestion for a gathering at hand. He would take so much pleasure in organizing events and the logistics of transporting everyone everywhere. He would roar from downstairs, "Let's rock and roll! All outs that's going out." The family concludes, "He was loved so, so much. We miss him. We know we will see each other again one day. Until then, rest easy. Don't worry, as we will take care of each other just as you would have." I'm now going to invite Charlie and Nolani to come forward, and they're going to read the Ron Tramner poem, Broken Chain, translated into the Doric for today.
Little Kent that morning, God was gan to call your name. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You didn't ging alone. For part, oh us, weren't we, the day God called you home. You left us peaceful memories. Your love is still your guide. And though we cannot see you, your eye was by our side. Our family chain is broken. Nothing seems the same, but as God cares, as in by in, the chain will link again.
Thank you, Charlie and Nolani, for that. As the poem suggests, the chains of love that we make in life are never entirely severed, even by death. And Sans was good at forging those links. As we've heard from Billy and from the rest of the family, his personality, along with his upbringing and early training in the hospitality industry, made him a natural networker, good at striking a bargain, good at having a conversation with whoever he met. I was struck by the fact that although he was well-traveled, his heart stayed local, as evidenced by the fact that after every journey abroad, the first meal once home needed to be mince and tatties with Skirly. He also loved the familiarity and regularity of the usual places and patters, like the Yangtze in Aberdeen for a Chinese. His interest in people and his desire to help others led to so many things, as we've heard, from coaching the young football teams or the Kemnay ladies, running the Ace of Spades discos, fundraising, running Kayleys for the Kemnay traders, or putting on Hogmanay discos, organizing stovey nights for the elderly, driving a school bus, and so forth. As the family shared, he loved living in the center of village life, happy to share news with everyone, lifting their spirits with some cheery chat, a cheeky remark, a wee wind-up, or a little side bet to make things interesting. That community commitment was a godsend during the first COVID lockdown, when he made things just a little bit more lighthearted for others. As we were all clapping for the NHS, he upped the ante by broadcasting a bit of disco from the garage in support. And he also ran quizzes and such to help people stay connected. Family remained the center for him always, and he was immensely proud of them all, taking an interest in everything that they were up to. Sans' enthusiastic "Let's rock and roll," followed by a "Nay rush, I'm in the car," will be much missed. But the links he formed in life remain strong in the memories, hearts and minds of all who loved him. We entrust him now to the unbroken love of God. Let us pray. Gentle and eternal God, today is a day of sadness, but it is also a day of thanksgiving. We give you thanks for all those who have shared our lives and helped to make them meaningful. In particular today, we thank you for Sans Elric. We thank you for the memories we've been able to share of this community-focused man who loved to help others and was always ready for the next adventure. There will be many more moments to be taken out, retold, and shared among the family over the days, months, and years to come. Thank you that we have stories to share, the happy ones, and even sometimes the more painful ones, which all form part of the complex weave of life. We know that in sharing stories, bonds of love are strengthened as we remember each other. Thank you also for the strengths of marriage, family, community, and friendship, which sustained Sans over many years. We thank you that Sans is now beyond any of the sickness, sorrow, and weariness of this earthly life. Even death is now past, and we entrust him to your love and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We finish this morning with another classic hymn, popular in both church and non-church settings, and recorded by the like of Ella Fitzgerald, Johnny Cash, and Willie Nelson. So with the memory and the strength of those connections that Sans leaves with us, let's sing together The Old Rugged Cross.
Thank you.
And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Please be seated.
I remember 62. I was 16 and so were you. And we lived next door on the avenue. Jerry Lee was big and Elvis too. Blue jeans and blue suede shoes. And we never knew what life held in store. We just wanted to rock and roll forevermore. We were the rock and roll kids. Rock and roll was all we did. And listening to those songs on the radio. I was yours and you were mine. That was once upon a time. Now we never seem to rock and roll anymore. Now Johnny's in love with the girl next door, and Mary's down at the record store. They don't want to be around us no more. Golden oldies, but we hardly speak. Too busy running to a different beat. Hard to understand. We were once like that. How I wish we could find those rock and roll days again. We were the rock and roll kids. Rock and roll. Listening to those songs on the radio. I was yours and you were mine. That was once upon a time. Now we never seem to rock and roll anymore. I was yours and you were mine. That was once upon a time. Now we never seem to rock and roll. We just never seem to rock and roll anymore.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm, there's a goal. sky and the sweet silver song of love. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, for your dreams beat us and blow.
Bring her coffee in the morning, she brings me in a piece. I take her out to fancy restaurants, she takes the sadness out of me. I make her cards on her birthday, she makes me a better man. I take her water when she's thirsty, she takes me as I'm. I love it when her mind wanders, and she loves it when I stay at home. I know when she's lost, and she knows when I feel alone. From all my airs and graces to the little things I do, the fire when it's cold out, and she lights up the room. I hope that she'll love me forever, she hopes I'll be back soon.